back to another one. Boy, howdy, it is 4:30 in the a.m. and we're about to go do a good little goose hunt over a little bit of water. I don't know if there's water there still. It might be dried up, but there should be a little bit of water left against some standing corn. I found it yesterday. There was about 2,000 birds in there, all lessers and specks. I didn't see one snow goose at all, so that's good. What do I mean by that's good? The more snow goose, the harder the hunt. That's really all I gotta say. But today has been a very requested video. Y'all have been telling me, Bobby, do the 6-shot challenge. That way, 6 birds is the Kansas limit, 6 shots, you know what I mean? So I kind of ramped it up a bit and I twisted it. I was like, why don't we do the 10-shot challenge? So it gives me a little buffer room, you know, if I make some mistakes. But let's make it a little more interesting. Now, I'm definitely not making it harder on myself, but we're gonna be shooting tungsten today, boys. These are the Federal 12-gauge TSS tungsten loads. These are, it's a 3-inch shell, 1¾, 9-shot, 100% tungsten, y'all. Cannons, absolute cannons. Federal does claim on the box that this will kill at 80 yards out of a 12 gauge. So, they are literally a powerhouse. So, hopefully I don't lose my shoulder. Hopefully it don't just fall off my body today. But real quick, I want to tell you about tungsten. So steel versus lead. Lead is 50% denser, basically heavier, than steel, right? So lead is 50% denser than steel. Tungsten is 110% denser than steel. So a lot of you, the myth has always been out there, is tungsten worth the money? Now, tungsten can get expensive, don't get me wrong. But over the last weekend when I had Federal down, they brought me, check it out, a plethora, a little grab bag of nothing but goodies. And in those goodies are a bunch of tungsten. And I shot them over the weekend and it changed my whole theory, my whole perception of tungsten versus steel. I was always like, ah, tungsten really ain't that good. It's just a marketing scheme to make more money. I beg to differ. Tungsten is no joke, y'all. So it's gonna be interesting on the GoPro, seeing the shot difference, the kill difference, the impact difference. So I'm gonna stop yapping. We're gonna get on the road. The weather, it's sitting at 29 degrees with a 15-mile-an-hour wind, so it's gonna be beautiful. North wind, that is. Well, we are burning down dirt roads. Here we are, this is our turn. And it just dawned on me, I'm like, I haven't even mentioned poor Frederick. I bet you guys are going, hey, whoa, Bob, is Fred going or not? He's not going today, and this is why. It's possibly a late on blind hunt, which I have to stop making that excuse. I have to get him dog blind trained, which we're doing that at home. We're doing it. I got a dog blind. I'll show y'all in another video. But the main reason why he's not going today is because I'm hunting with Ross and his dad. Y'all know who they are, Ross and Bill. We've hunted together a bunch, whether it's some of their little duck holes or their fields, just like this one. This is one of their lease properties, and I scouted it, and there's a ton of birds on it, so we're gonna go bang it, you know? But they have their dog, Ben, and Ben is a champion. This is his second full season, and he is an absolute stud muffin. This is gonna be a bigger hunt for Ben, so we're gonna let Ben do all the work today. He needs it. He needs to be on some big field hunts. You know, it's just out of respect. They have a dog. They've put a lot of investment in their dog, just like I have with Fred. This is their hunt. I'm just coming to shoot birds and film, you know what I mean? So in these situations, guys, I always encourage people to ask. Ask if you can bring your dog. Don't just bring your dog. If you're a client gonna go with an outfitter, even if you're paying, you need to ask if you can bring your dog. Now, they said I could. Yeah, sure, bring them. We'll run them both together. But I want them to be able to run Ben and Ben not be distracted and Fred be in Ben's way. Plus, Fred has been hunting his butt off. He needs a break. So that's my excuse for Fred not going. I hope it's a good enough one, because I feel bad. Every time Fred doesn't go, I do. I feel so bad for leaving him at home. All right, I gotta show you guys. I'm here at Ross's and his dad's beautiful pit. You guys have been here many, many times. This right here, you all have to see this. I'm not sure if we're gonna use it today. Even if we don't, I have to show you this. Oh boy, this is Bill's new toy. Bill is Ross's dad. Look, he's got LEDs all the way around the top of it. This is a six wheel, 1000cc Rotax Can-Am six wheeler. So yes, it is six wheel drive. Check it out. This back part, factory add-on, bolts on, drive shaft. How amazing is this? He said yesterday he had it in a swamp up to the door handle. He said it just trucked right through it. What did he say that's like, the number seventh off the line?
Seven or eight off the line,
like, I think. So number seven off the line for 2020.
Yeah, she's brand new. We're brand tearing new. Her up this year.
That is a brute. Oh my. Ooh, well, we are out here. Got a lovely east wind, y'all. The east wind that we got, it's running probably right at 15 mile an hour with gusts to maybe 18. It's supposed to be increasing throughout the morning, but it's perfect. Three man hunt, and we sat one A-frame underneath this tree. Lone tree out in the middle of a whole section. 18 dozen full bodies today, full bodies only. I think there might be a couple dozen spec full bodies, but the rest are just Canada Goose full bodies. We did the normal Bobby Guy spread here, which is basically a big U, you know, like a shallow U. And then it kind of drags over that way. Got a lot of decoys bunched up on the right side. But right here, this is what I've been doing, y'all, and it's been working a lot. So see how we got them bunched up on the right side, right? See this huge hole right here? Got a peninsula that drags out, a hole on the right for an option. And then on the left of that, you got another hole with another big body. A decoy is right here. This little W is basically what it is. It's a W with each right and left wing really heavy. Right here, this is where they're gonna be looking the hardest because we have an east wind, so they're gonna be coming at us just like this. So right here, if there's snow on the ground, I encourage you guys to put your sleeper shells there. Wherever the birds are gonna be concentrated the most, put some sleeper shells down, especially if it's really cold, you have ice on the ground or any snow. But today it's 37 degrees. It's a lovely Kansas morning. I'm gonna quit yapping. I'm excited. This is gonna be a little good one here. Even if we don't shoot a bunch, I love this little setup.
Look at this little lovely guy here though. Oh yeah.
Gonna put her right in there. Uh-huh, and just, there we go. Look at them on the left. Holy smokes, boys, here they come. Well, first group to get somewhat close here. Let's give them some noise. Hold on, are they specs or lessers? Spec, or no, they're lessers. I can't talk. Up top, boys, look at them. Get ready. Up front. Ha ha ha!
Yes! Tell me that wasn't the baddest thing you've ever seen in your life.
Let's
Dude! Woo-hoo! Yeah. I love it! Oh! Ah!
If you've never felt an adrenaline rush, call till your lungs hurt, till you can't move your lips, and make them give it up. Oh. Right there, that was a massive group. Oh, massive!
My face hurts.
Oh! It's so hard to do that. When you when you have to intrigue 300 pairs of eyes, that's hard. Dude, we did it. Oh. We called, we missed. One more. We missed! Golly! Oh. If you can't smash the thumbs up button for us, this is a three-man deal. I don't care what we shot. Yes! That's what it's about, boys. That right there.
That I can tell you one thing is I was so hyped that I didn't really even pay attention
to the ammunition, but I pounded that last speck that got out of the decoys. Wow, that was amazing. That was amazing.
If that don't deserve a thumbs up, guys, I don't know what to do here. I mean,
what else can you do?
What else?
That was one of the prettiest decoying, calling combo. I got so enamored with it, I didn't even see the 15 guy geese. Hey, I can't.
No, you're good. It'll go beep beep. It'll be funny. Shoot that bird. Shoot him. He ain't gonna land. Nice shot. Look at the birds out front. Hey, I didn't see them out front.
They flew over. We are.
Oh, they did.
Them, yeah.
Well, they're coming. Oh, those are all specks, boys. Oh, that sounds amazing.
Oh, that does sound good.
Man, it's like 10:30. We got about a third of the spread picked up. Check it out. Oh yeah, that's the way to do it, y'all. Rally up. One guy goes and gets a truck. Whoever's left, you make a pile. So then you park the trailer right by it, and it's easy to load it all. You know what I mean? But check this out. Look at this. A baseball. Look at that. Oh, be darned. Ross, catch! That was like, dude, that was a bomber. That actually probably would have hurt to catch. Woo, working our butt off. Well, I know the tungsten challenge. One thing, I did kill one speck, and I can tell you that it wasn't very close. You're talking a 35, 40 yard shot. Smoked him. The tungsten is no joke, guys. If you guys have the money to buy tungsten, I recommend it. Especially if you're going to be doing some pass shooting or something like that. Try it out. You'll like it. But one thing, you guys have been saying, Bobby. Get down. You guys have been saying, Bobby. No. He's trying to hunt me. He's trying to hunt me, Ben. That's not cool, Ben. You're trying to hunt me and I don't like it. Get back. Get back. I guarantee if I put my leg out like that, it's game over. Game over. But you guys have been missing the Foul Fridays, and I've been getting a lot of comments saying, Bobby, I only have this many, you know, greenhead decoys. The till are gone. Should I put them away for the season? Guys, I'm going to tell you right now, it doesn't matter what type of decoys you have. Whatever you have, throw them out. Today we have probably four different brands of goose decoys. And here is a good example. We sat out probably six of these speck decoys that have no head on them. I do it all the time. We lose heads in the field. We lose them. They flop off. They're just gone. We still use those decoys. Just because those decoys don't have heads doesn't mean they're not going to work. You just don't be picky with decoys. Put stuff out there. It looks like birds. Call as good as you can. Kill what you can. Well, we are back home indeed, and look at this. Oh, Frederick, look at him, set. Here, better yet. We've been working in the backyard a bunch, I mean a ton. Fred, place. Good boy. We've been working a lot.
Been working on him staying, him sitting, him not moving, right? Trying to cure this breaking situation. So I'll make him place, sit, and he's doing awesome. I can go inside. I can cook dinner. I can be on the phone for probably, I've pushed him about 5 to 7 minutes at a time. That's what we'll do right now. And it's really helping. He's doing great. But as far as tungsten, the tungsten challenge. Using tungsten, I mean, it's really not a challenge, right? And the 10 shots, I didn't even pull the trigger 10 times. Really, that one go was the only go we got. And that's honestly okay with me, because when you trick big, big masses of birds like that, that was 200 to 300 eyes, you know? That's awesome. I mean, that is gratifying. That deserves a pat on the back. That right there, you take home with you. Who cares if you have any birds? I only shot one speck on that hunt. That was actually last week. And let me tell you, I was fine with that. I didn't need to shoot. I would have been fine if I hadn't shot anything. Just me tricking those birds. Two callers, just yapping away. We're not the best callers in the world, by no means. We suck. And we still tricked them birds. Good boy. He's a good boy. Still tricked them. When you can trick that many eyes, I'm telling you what, you did something right. You worked hard enough. You claimed it. It was your reward for the hunt. So, I know the 10 shot challenge, tungsten. I didn't kill a lot of birds. None of us did. Again, I will have to tell you, if you have the money for tungsten, go get it. If you plan on going, let's say, to a public land situation on a firing line and pass shooting geese, or maybe you're just thinking, man, today I bet it's going to be some high shots. I better have a shot that can go 40, 50 yards if I want it to. That's what tungsten's for, guys. Now, yes, it is a pricey deal, but if you're planning on needing an ammo that is going to do its job at long range out of your shotgun, I will tell you, Federal tungsten loads are money.
Still a good boy.
We're 3 minutes deep into this little scene here. And like I said, I've been doing rounds of 5 to 7 minutes at a time. When I let him down, I praise him. I give him a treat. I give him a break for a little bit. And then I hit him with it again. Put him up there, make him go another 5 to 10 minutes. We've been doing this placing stuff probably 5 to 10 times a day. So I am doing my best to get Fred to stop breaking. I don't want him breaking. I don't want to have to leash him. We got an e-collar on him now, which, just wait for that video. It's a great video. But thank y'all for being here.
Fred, if he could talk, he would thank y'all for being here.
Fred literally has became a bigger part of this channel than I am. I appreciate you guys a lot. Appreciate all your positive comments, your positive vibes, all the support from you guys. Thank you so much. And if you want to help support the channel, there's a few ways. The first way is to buy something from duckswaterfowl.com, like this matching beanie and thermal hoodie combo. I will link it down in the description below if you want to do that. Or just letting the ads play. A lot of you ask me, Bobby, I don't have money for ducks. How else can I help you out? How else can I support the channel directly? Let the ads play, guys. Those ads, they pay the bills. So if you want to help me, just let them play. And you can always subscribe and hit that notification bell down there, because that notification bell, it notifies you when your boy uploads. Thank you all for being here. Be sure to let me know down in the comments what videos y'all want me to do. You know I'm active down there. You know I comment back. You know I reply. But until next time.